I think what we're seeing today is really the growth of an industry, the growth of a way of doing things which is far more sophisticated and integrated than it has been at any time in the past. In the early days of the New Communities program, there were many good organizations who were working very hard to make individual projects happen. But over time, they began to link up, form partnerships, they began to work with each other, they began to link and make connections within communities so that they could create something that was even better and bigger and more impactful.
I think a lot of our NCP staff are just really smart and capable and able to apply themselves to different domains because it's really a people skill and a project management skill and a convening skill.
They're from the neighborhood, so they know their community in a way that somebody from the outside just doesn't. But the other thing that they're really good at is building relationships amongst a wide variety of people, both within their neighborhoods and people who work outside of their neighborhoods.
Because of this New Communities program platform and the work of lead agencies and faith-based organizations and strong political partners, we've really been able to engage those same residents that were afraid to come out, and now they have taken leadership roles and really have manhandled a revitalization of their own community.
I look at this work sometimes and wonder why I wasn't doing it sooner. It is extremely hard work, but it's, on the other hand, extremely rewarding. You're not just working with community organizations, you're also working with local political leadership, you're also working with the folks downtown at City Hall. They're bringing in corporate partners. This platform allows you to bring everybody together to work as one.
They look at us as not a community of full of all these deficiencies, but a community that has local strengths. And they support those strengths on a local level, and they allow us as a community to be able to address our, you know, social issues. Because a lot of people have a very one-dimensional view of neighborhoods, especially what are considered as, you know, working poor neighborhoods, and that's that nobody there cares, somebody needs to come in from outside and rescue them, but really a lot of times it's just a lack of resources.
It's probably now more important than ever that we be in these neighborhoods and are working with them. Our neighborhoods are the last to benefit from economic turnaround and the first to suffer from the economic downturn. So our groups have to be there to play a role to sort of mitigate those challenges, but also they're there to help take advantage of opportunities that when they present themselves. There's a lot of work going on in the CWFs to prepare people to get jobs. There's a lot of work around what kind of affordable housing development should happen in communities and how they can take advantage of the foreclosure crisis to provide housing for families. There's a lot of discussion about the importance of education in this economic environment, so a lot of our groups are expanding their work in schools to improve the quality of education in communities. All of these things would lead to a much brighter future for our neighborhoods because the groups have the infrastructure to really make it happen.